Welcome to This Week in Astronomy, brought to you by Celestron, the world's leading manufacturer of telescopes. I'm Dave Eicher, editor of Astronomy magazine. This week, we have a really good event to monitor. It's one of the good meteor showers of the year. This is the April Lyrid meteor shower. You never know quite what's going to happen when you go out and look up and try to see meteors, little streaks from little tiny particles in the trail of an asteroid or comet or another body in our solar system that Earth's orbit intersects. So the April Lyrid meteor shower is a good one. It's one of the first really good ones in our spring. It's active mostly from about April 15th to the 29th, and it peaks more or less on April 23rd, although you can see meteors, of course, for days before and after that. All you need to do with a meteor shower is simply to head out to a dark sky, look up away from city lights, and try to get as good a sky as you can. The moon interferes a bit this year, but it won't be that big a deal in putting a damper on this. And you may see as many as 20 meteors per hour from the Lyrid shower. Of course, as with any meteor shower, the meteors are best between about midnight and 4 a.m. when Earth's leading edge turns into the meteor storm. The source of the April Lyrids is comet 1861 G3 Thatcher, an old-time comet, and we're passing through that stream of debris. So head out in April, get a clear sky away from city lights, and see if you can see streaks from small particles that were left behind by a comet long ago. I'll see you next time.